guys. I'm going to speak on a very interesting topic today, how technology can liberalize the tax systems in India. Okay, so taxation has been there in our country and on this entire planet since last, say 2000 years. Since kingdoms and Akbar and everyone used to tax general public to run their economy and everything. Why are tax important? You cannot have roads, you cannot have airports, you cannot run a country without taxation. But our country is a bit strange, 90% of the taxes are not paid at all. We all know that internally. They're not paid, they're always tax loopholes. In fact, one of the biggest telecom giants somehow use this loophole legally, and he made a big company out of it. He invested more than 2 lakh crore in infrastructure, in building towers and everything. That was legal. It was a legal loophole to invest in towers, to invest in the fiber lines, and save that 30% tax. And now it is one of the biggest telecom company out there. If we compare all the countries in the world by their GDPs, let's say that a country is a factory, and every factory has got revenue, turnover, how much money they how much cash flows in, basically. So this is a GDP. 2 years back, 2.5 trillion. Right now, 2.5 trillion US dollars. That's 12 lakh crore Indian rupees. Sounds a lot, but entire country. With population of 140 crore has GDP of 2.5 trillion and a country with population of just 7 crore has got a GDP higher than us. A country with similar population, you can see here, China, has got a GDP of 12.2 trillion crores. That was 2 years back. Now it has reached around 18 trillion crores. And US, of course, right now it's at 23 trillion crores. If you see top 50 companies out there in the world, if you see top 10 companies, none of them is Indian. Top 50 companies, only 2 companies are there. One is TCS and another one is Reliance. 2 companies are there in top 50 companies. Just 2 Indian companies. Why is that? Why aren't we innovative? Why our companies are not that big enough? This is the biggest reason why our country is poor. Why do we have bad roads? Every problem arises from here. Because we don't have cash flowing in. This is a poor country, that is the fact. Yes, we are growing and we can say that our GDP is increasing at 7%, 8%, that's not enough. A population of 140 crores and GDP of just 2.5 trillion crore. Recently, Subramanyam Swami, he quoted that India can get ready to say goodbye to 5 trillion dollar economy. India, the current government has got target to reach to 5 trillion within 5 years by 2023. That's a good target. But he's a neutral politician. He says that India should say goodbye to it, because neither boldness alone nor knowledge can save the economy from a crash. It needs both. Today we have neither. That's true. If you want to get paid higher, you will obviously shift to United States. You'll get 10 times more salary than in India. Everywhere you see, everything in India is 10 times cheaper. Your pay is low. If you start a business in US, my IT company caters to the US market entirely. I've banned Indian companies to work with me, because the pay is higher. For the things, I get paid $10 here, I get paid $200 out there. And I get surprised that for such a small task, I'm getting paid 20 times more. Why is that? So, what if I tell you there's one magic solution to all these problems? To all the problems out you see, economic slowdown, corruption, easy tax collection, and ease of doing business. These 4 things. Economic slowdown, we can all see it, slowly, our country is getting it's increasing, but the economists say that a GDP is the percentage, the rate is narrowing a bit, and the corruption is always there. always, it's like, you know, inevitable. Now, ease of doing business, that's where we are going wrong. That's where all the governments have gone wrong. The biggest challenge here is the government, the people, they think that the businessmen out there, they are criminals and they should be put behind bars. Why is that? They aren't doing anything wrong, they just know the tax loopholes, they use it. It's easy for them to use the tax loopholes and they use it. Anyone would do that. If you are not using the tax loopholes, your competitor would use and he'll get ahead of you. I know few Indian clients who have got no other choice to use the tax loopholes or, like, you know, to pay taxes. If they start paying taxes, their factories will shut down because the competitor is not paying that 18% GST. And when you have turnover of 700 crores, that 18% comes to 100 crores. That's his entire margin. So, the one magic solution to all the problems, to end corruption, to grow our economy, to become a better country, to have a bigger GDP, there's one solution to it, and that is liberation. If you see in this picture, this is equality. Equality is everyone is equal. This is how other countries operate. This is how, like, you know, people out there operate. Like, you know, if you want to see the baseball match, you get, like, you know, you put equal, like, slabs for everything, and, you know, the rich pays. This is what the government thinks the problem is, the equality. So they put it in equity. They charge low taxes to the poor, they charge high taxes to the rich, and medium taxes to the middle class. There are different tax slabs for everyone. But they don't understand that they need to bring the liberation, they need to remove that wall. Those big businesses are the ones which will get the money flowing in the economy. They cannot keep that in their pocket. They'll put that in their bank accounts, either they'll use it to grow their company, they'll buy more factories, they'll expand it, they'll create more jobs, and they'll grow the country. How many private jets will they buy? How many big cars will they buy? After 100 or 200 crores, it's all over. After that, only you can invest in your business. That's the real truth. I don't think after 50 million, there's anything you can, like, you know, buy in this world. So we need to bring liberation. And how do we bring liberation out there? Liberation means solving the biggest problem out there, that is the poverty, that is bringing in more money. Even the poor, by doing a part-time job, should earn $7 to $8 per hour. That's how they earn in USA. They do part-time jobs at Burger King, McDonald's, and fast food chains, and they earn a lot. When I was in England 5 years back, one of my roommate, he was a British resident, and he used to work at a nearby super dry showroom, and he used to just fold clothes and all, just on Saturday and Sunday. He used to work 8.5 hours on Saturday and 8.5 hours on Sunday, and he used to earn £600 per month. That was good enough for him to pay his rent, to pay for his food. I was shocked. An IT engineer here, a PHP developer, a Java developer, earns, like, you know, 60-70k after 5 years of experience. And he's just folding clothes out there in England. He's earning 60,000. That was in 2012. And now it has increased. So this is because that country is rich. That country has got more money. That's the truth. So how do we bring liberation? It seems like a big word, motivational. Now let's come to the actual reality. How do we bring it? There's just one solution, one magic solution. That is a banking transaction tax. Yes, it sounds like something new to most of the people, but a banking transaction tax is something which will make this country a superpower. How will it make a country super? How can a tax make a country superpower? Confusing, right? Okay, I'll tell you a few facts about it. A banking transaction tax basically is levied on all the credit transactions. Credit, that means the money which is coming in, the money which you are earning. Okay, not the money you're paying. So, by abolishing all the taxes, by abolishing GST, income tax, excise duty, all the taxes out there, it'll be easier for businesses to grow. Today, the small business is indulged in filing GST and filing income tax. Like 30% of his time, 30 to 40% of the business's time goes in filing taxes. The mental pressure which taxations bring on small businesses. Big business anyhow uses loopholes to loot the tax. But the small businessmen who actually pay the tax, they have to spend a lot of time to save taxes. Somehow they also try to get around it, but still they spend a lot of mental energy. They spend a lot of lots and lots of resources. They have to go to their CA all the time, and they have to put in a lot of effort to get around it. And they'll always get around it because it's a habit in a country. So my idea here is 2% GST on all the money that is coming in your bank account. And the 2% will accumulate to 14 to 50% in the cycle. Think deep like an accountant over here. If you are from an accounting background, you'll know what a cascading effect is. Like, I get money from, let's say, I'm doing a job, I get money. Like 2% automatically gets debited. Then I pay that money to pay my bills. 2% gets debited over there. Then that guy pays to his employers and all. So the round, the cycle, it reaches to 14 to 15%. How is it beneficial for the country? The biggest reason is that it makes easier for everyone. Easier for government to collect taxes, easier for businesses to do businesses without maintaining books of accounts, and easier for everyone out there. Like an auto wala, if gets paid 1,000 rupees, he pays 20 rupees. 2%, that's 2%. And if a businessman who's earning 1 crore pays 2 lakh rupees, that's a difference. So our auto wala is paying just 20 rupees, but there are few challenges over here. Like, how will you crack down the black money over here? So of course you'll have to ban all the notes till rupees 50. Yeah, that sounds astonishing, but if my driver can use WhatsApp and send me Hindi good morning messages every morning, he can learn Paytm also. Easy. And I think a guy who needs to transact more than like notes bigger than of denomination of 50, then that guy does not need any paint, like that guy does not need any software. Because if you are using Paytm, if you are using wallets, online wallets, automatically your 2% gets debited. That's right. If the PTT applies, of course. So the question here arises, how will the farmers, how will the poor of this country will actually use this? How will they, they use their smartphones, and how will they operate without the denominations of bigger notes? It's easy. The 2% gets divided by central government, the state government, and the local government. 75% of the 2% goes to the central government, because that goes to the defense of this country. Rest 25% gets divided between the state government, the local authorities, and the transacting body, be it a bank, be it a wallet or anything. This large amount of cut on every transaction will provoke those banks, those wallet companies, to teach everyone how to use those wallets. When demonetization came, every shopkeeper out there, they had their Paytm ka, they had barcode. They started using Paytm. Similarly, everyone can use bank accounts, and this is the time. Timing is everything. Now we all have smartphones. Today or tomorrow, this thing will come. Banking transaction tax will come, definitely. Not today, maybe after 15 years, but it will come. Why? Either we can bring it right now or later, but it will come, definitely. That is why, because it's the need. It's necessary. Government cannot spend thousands and thousands of people, officers, on collecting taxes and coming around it and everything will be legal. Corruption will end. Doing business in India would be easy. economy will thrive. That's the real solution. It is a real solution if you think about it. There are a few challenges, but how can we implement it in such a big country? There will be such a big risk, like GST nearly cracked down our economy, like, you know, demonetization, it gave so much of, like, you know, bad words to the government. So how can they implement this? So the solution is by implementing this tax system in a small state like Goa or any small state, and if it works, you can put it into the entire country, put it into all the states. That's how it will work. It's simple. If you're not growing, you're just slowing down, and India needs to grow now, and this tax system is of future. Black money, corruption, ease of doing business, many advantages. Currently, only one country on this planet is using this tax system, which is Finland, and it's quite successful over there, working very well. So if we need to end corruption, if we need to grow our economy, if we need to thrive, we need to get a new kind of thinking in this system, and I personally think this transaction tax, banking transaction tax, is the solution. Thank you.